The Holy Spirit is what you get only if you get like passed out and like fall on the ground. You know, if you get the Holy Spirit, you're gonna be an even bigger target, right? I don't think the Holy Spirit is like really even around anymore. I think it's just like the consciousness of like the universe. You don't need the Holy Spirit because we don't have miracles in this day. That passed when Jesus was around. Why do you need the Holy Spirit just to be a good person? You can just make good choices, right? Are any of those things actually true? Let's find out today.
God is the father that I never knew I had.
God simply is everything.
God is faithful.
God is my strength.
God is always the answer.
God is a promise keeper.
God is very powerful.
God is my wonderful counselor.
God is compassionate to me.
God is perfect.
Love. God is love. You may have a lot of questions about your walk with God, so let's talk about it. Hello and welcome to another L'amour in Christ video. I'm Kytia L'amour and today we are talking about the Holy Spirit, one part of the Trinity, Father, Son, and Holy Spirit. Some of you guys have asked me this before for months and months and months, and now I finally felt on my heart that God wanted me to share about this. Last week we talked about baptism and you guys had some really, really good insight and some really cool things. Also, congratulations again to those who recently got baptized or made the decision to get baptized. I just think that's really awesome. So today we're talking about the Holy Spirit, and I'm doing things in a particular order on purpose. So we talked about baptism, but part of baptism is Jesus told his disciples to go and make disciples of all nations, baptizing them in the name of the Father and the Son and the Holy Spirit. And some of you guys asked about what does it mean to be baptized in the Spirit, and some of you have been told by the churches or someone else that it means that you speak in tongues. I've even been told that being baptized in the Spirit, the evidence is you speak in tongues, and that comes from the book of Acts. We're going to be talking about that and decoding a couple of things. But I also did want to bring up again, I talked about this briefly last time in being baptized, that when Jesus was baptized and the Holy Spirit came down on him in the form of a dove, that was like a precursor to, I guess, an example that we as believers, as Christ followers, would also be able to receive the gift of the Holy Spirit to rest and to stay on us, which was not very common in the Old Testament. There were people who had the Spirit of God come on them. Some of them it stayed, and some of them it was just for specific assignments. Like I remember in Samson, in the book of Judges, where he had specific assignments that God gave him, and it would say the Spirit of God came on him, gave him this mighty strength, and it kind of magnified the gifts that he already had. He was already strong, he was already witty, but it would give him even more wisdom to be a judge and a leader over people. It would give him even more strength to do supernatural things. So as far as the Holy Spirit's purpose, it is about having the Spirit of God reside in us and also magnifying our spiritual gifts and the strengths that we already have and doing things that are supernatural. This is a part of supernatural warfare, which is gonna be, I think, next week, I don't remember, but it's coming up about spiritual warfare too. So all of these things tie in together, but let's start off in the Word. What does the Word say about the Holy Spirit? So first we're gonna go into, when did the disciples get the Holy Spirit? So in John 14, Jesus is comforting his disciples because the disciples still don't understand the fact that Jesus has to go back to heaven. And they're like, why are you leaving us? This is really sad. What do we do when you're gone? And so in John 14, he says, starting in verse 23, Jesus replied, anyone who loves me will obey my teaching. My Father will love them, and we will come to them and make our home with them. Anyone who does not love me will not obey my teaching. These words you hear are not my own. They belong to the Father who sent me. All this I have spoken while still with you. But the Advocate, the Holy Spirit, whom the Father will send in my name, will teach you all things and remind you of everything I have said to you. Peace I leave with you. My peace I give you. I do not give you as the world gives. Do not let your hearts be troubled and do not be afraid. So before he left, he was basically sending instructions to people saying, you guys are going to be okay. You will have help in the Holy Spirit. And I think they were still like, what does this mean? Because it's kind of a concept that is a little uncommon for them at the time to say, like, what do you mean it's going to help us? What do you mean it's going to teach us? And that is something to keep in mind when you think about the Holy Spirit, is it's reminding you things that Jesus taught. It's giving you wisdom. It's giving you understanding of the word. But if we're not in our Bibles, if we're not reading it, how can the Holy Spirit bring up things that we should know? How is it going to remind us of Jesus's teachings and the things that the Bible says if you're not reading it, if you're not studying it, if you're not being prayerful about seeking God's will and understanding and having discernment? So that is very important. So let's go ahead and fast forward into the book of Acts and talk about how the disciples receive the Holy Spirit for the first time. So Acts chapter 2, verses 1 through 5. When the day of Pentecost came, they were all together in one place. This is the Jesus' disciples. Suddenly, a sound like the blowing of a violent wind came from heaven and filled the whole house where they were sitting. They saw what seemed to be tongues of fire that separated and came to rest on each one of them. All of them were filled with the Holy Spirit and began to speak in other tongues as the Spirit enabled them. And this is like right when they're about to start their ministry of discipling people, getting them baptized and everything. And one thing to also remember is they were filled with the Spirit and began to speak in other tongues as the Spirit enabled them. And we're going to get into spiritual gifts because this does talk about, am I supposed to speak in tongues? Am I supposed to be able to do this? Am I supposed to be able to do that? Is this evidence of the Holy Spirit, of me being baptized in the Holy Spirit? So let's talk about some more things that the Holy Spirit does though. We are going to start in Luke 24, 45 through 49. This is talking about Jesus. Then he opened their minds so they could understand the scriptures. He told them, "This is what is written. The Messiah will suffer and rise from the dead on the third day. And repentance for the forgiveness of sins will be preached in his name to all nations, beginning at Jerusalem. You are witnesses of these things. I'm going to send you what my Father has promised, but stay in the city until you have been clothed with power from on high." And I think what's important of this too, Jesus is letting them know, this is what's going to happen. I'm going to die. I'm going to rise again and be resurrected. And then I'm going to be preaching forgiveness and repentance, which is basically all of our jobs as believers, is to share the message of Jesus Christ, what he did on the cross, and why everyone has the ability to be forgiven if they surrender their lives, if they accept Jesus Christ into their lives and obey him. So their forgiveness and repentance, turning their lives around. And he also said, "I'm going to give you what the Father has promised," talking about the Holy Spirit, "but stay in the city until you have been clothed with power from on high." And I think that this is important too, when we even talk about being in any form of ministry or spiritual leadership. Even though the disciples were with Jesus for a long time, they saw a lot of things, they were with him, they witnessed a lot of stuff, but before they were sent out into their ministry, into their mission field, he said, make sure that you have the power of God on you first. Because speaking of spiritual warfare, the devil wants to come after you. He wants to annihilate you, no matter if you believe in God or not. But also, if you are entering into spiritual warfare and you're coming in on the offense and you're like starting stuff basically in the spiritual realm, you want to make sure that you are covered in God's strength, his power, and his authority. He's serious about that because he wants us to be protected. So that's a part of that too. Now we're going into Romans 8. This will be, I think this is the last scripture. No, it's not. Romans 8, 2 through 6. "Because through Christ Jesus, the law of the Spirit who gives life has set you free from the law of sin and death. For what the law was powerless to do because it was weakened by the flesh, God did by sending his own Son in the likeness of sinful flesh to be a sin offering. And so he condemned sin in the flesh in order that the righteous requirement of the law might fully be met in us, who do not live according to the flesh, but according to the Spirit. Those who live according to the flesh have their mind set on what the flesh desires, but those who live in accordance with the Spirit have their minds set on what the Spirit desires. The mind governed by the flesh is death, but the mind governed by the Spirit is life and peace." So that also has to do with submitting and surrendering to the will of the Holy Spirit that is inside of us. Having the Holy Spirit isn't just a privilege of like telling people what to do, acting like you're super holy. It is so that you can surrender to God's will and God's authority. And the Holy Spirit is there to remind you, like, you know, sometimes when you're doing something wrong and you're just like, I feel like convicted about that. Like I just feel off. Like I know I shouldn't be stealing, or I know I shouldn't be thinking these things or doing this. The spirit is like, that's right. Like, don't do that. You need to do this, but you're not gonna know that unless you're spending quality time with God, in the word, in prayer, in worship, and being still. And please watch my video called How I Learned to Hear God's Voice More Clearly, because I talk a lot more about how I learned to hear God's voice more clearly. And a lot of that had to do with sitting in God's presence, getting rid of distractions, and completely surrendering and renewing my mind to what the Spirit wants to do. So now we're going to talk about with being baptized in the Holy Spirit, and what does that mean? Basically, simply being baptized in the name of the Father, Son, and the Holy Spirit is recognizing that there is a Father, a Son, a Holy Spirit, making the decision that you're going to follow God and Father, Son, and Holy Spirit, which we call the Trinity, three in one. I guess I'm trying to figure out if some of you guys are asking, is it like a thing you do, like somebody has to do a special Holy Spirit like thing on you or something? It just comes when you surrender your life, and like part of proclaiming that in public is being baptized and doing what God tells you to do. But yeah, as far as the Holy Spirit, it comes when you surrender your life to God, and we have it resting in us, but we have to make sure that we're not clouding it with our fleshly desires and still doing what we want to do. We should be obeying God and loving Him and following His commands. But each of us do have gifts, spiritual gifts that we need in order to help this world, in order to fulfill our purpose and our calling. So let's go ahead and talk about that. So 1 Corinthians 12, it says concerning spiritual gifts. Verse 4, there are different kinds of gifts, but the same Spirit distributes them. There are different kinds of service, but the same Lord. There are different kinds of working, but in all of them and everyone is the same God at work. Now to each one, the manifestation of the Spirit is given for the common good, like the common good of the body of Christ. To one there is given through the Spirit a message of wisdom, to another a message of knowledge by means of the same Spirit, to another faith by the same Spirit, to another gifts of healing by that one Spirit, to another miraculous powers, to another prophecy, to another distinguishing between spirits, to another speaking in different kinds of tongues, and to still another the interpretation of tongues. All of these are the work of one and the same Spirit, and He distributes them to each one just as He determines. So, when you talk about the body of Christ, you hear the example a lot in the Word about, okay, we're a body, so there's a head, there's arms, there's feet, there's hands, there's eyes, there's ears. And because we all have a specific purpose that God Himself decides for us and a calling, it's because He wants us to have community. He wants us to need each other and not just be like, I can do whatever I want to, like I have all the gifts, like I'm super powerful. And so when you think about your spiritual gifts, there may be things practical. This is a practical way of kind of figuring out things. Is for me, for example, I've always had like, I would say like a spiritual wisdom about things, or like a knowing about things, like this is gonna happen, or the phone rings and I already know who's on the other line without looking at it, or I'm just able to make decisions very quickly, or be able to teach things in a way that people can understand, or just be encouraging. So those things are a part of like my makeup. I've always been like that. It wasn't like this huge new thing. It was just that when I became a Christ follower and submitted my life to Him, they were magnified and they became like supernatural things that I could understand were from the Lord and how to use them. So let's say, for example, my husband has different gifts. He has like really huge, big faith, and he has now dreams. So he gets spiritual dreams where he'll dream about something or someone and it ends up happening, or God will give him instructions as he's sleeping in his dream. And I do that too, but definitely not to the degree that he does. Like, he definitely has way more dreams than I'd say I would that are spiritual, supernatural dreams, and even getting visions where he's like, I'm awake, but I'm seeing like something happening in the future. And similar to my mom, her prophetic word is like always on point, and she has dreams and visions, and all of us speak in tongues. That's something that we ask the Lord for. And I believe that there's a scripture, I forget right now, about asking for different gifts, and the number one thing that God does say to ask for is the gift of prophecy, because basically, even if you're talking about the gift of tongues, which people put on this huge pedestal way up here, like if you don't speak in tongues, are you really saved? But even in the Word, it talks about if you're speaking in tongues, over people, but nobody can interpret those tongues. Like, nobody's being edified, basically, because nobody knows what you're talking about. And even for you, there will be times when you're speaking in tongues, and if you're really in tune with God, you can kind of tell what you're praying about, like what the subject matter is, and like it'll start to sound a little bit differently, or be a different type of pace, or different like syllables and stuff. So that's something that I've noticed in my walk in speaking in tongues. So I definitely wouldn't say like, oh, if you don't speak in tongues, like you're not saved until you do that. And I don't even know where this whole thing started. I think it was basically people used the book of Acts and the disciples getting the Holy Spirit for the first time as a measure of, are you really somebody chosen by God? Are you really, like, really saved? Because all of them were given that gift right then to speak in other tongues. But that doesn't mean that everybody has to do that, or that that is the litmus test for being a Christian. So I would say definitely, if I could give you an assignment this week, is to write down some of the things that you've noticed about yourself as far as things that don't make sense. They seem paranormal, or they seem like, am I a psychic? Am I a mind reader? Like, because that's what Satan uses to pervert gifts. When people enter into the spiritual realm without God, you will have things like psychics. People can manifest like something out of nothing and do like crazy like magic and spells and stuff. Like, the enemy perverts everything, so that's why there's that whole realm, because he wants to fight against us. But we have the victory, we have the power, we have the real one and truly mighty God who has all the power. So make sure that you are understanding what those things are in you, so that you can pray about that, like, God, help me to hone in on those gifts, because he's given them to you for a reason. So if you dream about stuff and you're like, that was weird, maybe if you dreamt about something that has to do with someone else, like, tell them, like, oh, I had this dream about you, like, does that bring up anything? And I've done that before too, and people were like, oh my gosh, like, I think I dreamt about someone getting into real estate, and I was like, I don't know, you guys were having an open house, I didn't know you were into real estate. And they were just like, yeah, we're actually flipping a house right now, and like, we didn't tell anybody we're getting into real estate. So just having those kind of things, like, it makes you feel like, yeah, we tight, like, me and God are talking about stuff over here. So I'd say it's very encouraging when you understand your gifts and why you may be super patient, why you may be able to pray for someone and their back is healed instantly, or why even by singing and worshiping, you just notice the atmosphere change and different things like that. But I mean, these are our weapons, guys. Like, we need to know what our weapons are. So take that very, very seriously, what it means to be baptized in the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit. You need the Holy Spirit to help you live a righteous life, but also to edify the body of Christ. So let's go ahead and pray about that, in case you're dealing with some doubts or still a little bit confused about it. I just want to pray over you guys. So I just thank you, Lord God, for this time. Thank you for everyone who made it here today, who clicked on that video. Thank you for those who are wanting to know more about the power that is in the Holy Spirit and what is it for. And even for those who have felt very condemned, like, oh, you don't speak in tongues, you don't do this, you can't prophesy, like, you're not a real Christian. So I just pray against that condemnation right now. Please help them to be free and healed from that and be able to know in your truth and what your word says, so that they can live by your word and not what other people think or say or what their opinions are. So I just thank you for covering them. Help them to see what different gifts you've put in them, spiritual or just talents that they have, that they're meant to use for their purpose, because we need to be walking in our purpose and intentionally pursuing our calling in Christ. So I thank you, Lord, that you want us to know these things, and I just pray you reveal the truth. In Jesus' name, I pray, amen. That's all I have for today. Thank you so much for hanging out with me. Let me know if you learned something new, or if you have an additional thing that you want to share with us, or even just what are your gifts? Like, I think that would be really cool to know. What are your spiritual gifts down there? I know that you guys definitely have been praying for me, and I appreciate that. Thank you for your support. Another way of supporting this channel and keeping videos coming is to buy my merchandise. I wear my shirts in every video, but I also have pillows, I have wall art, I have blankets, I have all kinds of stuff. So if you want to, that is linked in the description box. And if you want to send a donation of any amount, there's also a secure PayPal link down there. Any amount is fine. And also, your prayers, like I said, are very supportive. Any way that you support me, I'm just very, very grateful for it. And so I want to see you guys again. So if you want to see me, I'm here on Wednesdays. I'm here on Sundays, and I'll be talking about more lifestyle and personal things and beauty and fashion on Wednesdays. And on Sundays, I'm here talking about my walk with God and what God is doing in my life and sharing things that He is teaching me. So if you want to see that, go ahead and click on the subscription button. And also don't forget to click that little bell so that you'll be notified the moment that I post. And I will see you in my next video. Bye. The Holy Spirit is what you get.
Oh, no.
Hello. Are you recording though?
Okay.
Whoa, I didn't even turn on the light.